Good evening. Welcome back to my Life at Home concerts. I'm gonna start playing tonight with the last prelude from the book 2 of the Well-Tempered Clavier by Johann Sebastian Bach, the B minor. Bach quite possibly did not like long goodbyes, and this piece is short and understated, although it has a couple of really important for him quotes from his own other music. And yet, we already know what's gonna happen, and we're just gonna go on with it. Somebody's getting on the train and departing. I hope you enjoy. very, very wonderful. Very wonderful prelude. On the way out. Next, I'm gonna play a piece that I have written for, well, not to play, but for Joe Grandson, because at one point I was at Venkman's, as we used to be at Venkman's at all times, and I walk in, and Joe is at the microphone and goes like, "Misha is here," and then he looks at me and goes like, "What are you wearing?" So I wrote this piece that is called "What Are You Wearing?" And it's a creative endeavor in time signatures. It's like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the bridge is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So, I told him that I wrote it, and he was like, "Well, let's play it." So we put it on, gave music to everybody, and we played about 6 measures of it correctly. And after that, it was a complete train wreck. It was wonderful, great. Like, nobody knew what was happening. So I'm going to attempt to play that. It's called "What Are You Wearing?" And you can actually shout the phrase with the melody, like, "What are you wearing? What are you wearing? Debbity-bitty-bitty, what are you wearing? What are you wearing? Debbity-bitty-bitty." It's like this. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, de-de-de. What are you wearing? What are you wearing? Debbity-bitty-bitty, what are you wearing? What are you wearing? Debbity-bitty-bitty. Promising, isn't it? Let's see how it works out. It's so fun, and it's so hard, and it's very short and very simple, but so hard. Anyways, "Never Let Me Go" is the next piece I'm going to play, and I hope you enjoy that. Wonderful, wonderful melody. I'm gonna play one more. This one is a Russian song. I've talked about it before, but it was long, long time ago. So I'm gonna do that again. What is it called? На том же месте, в тот же час is the Russian name for this. There might be... Oh, it's called Неудачное свидание. Actually, it has a title, which means unsuccessful date. And there are two people singing. And he starts singing and he talks about how he went to the date that they had set up and she wasn't there. And in the chorus, they're singing, I was there, and she goes like, and I was there too. And then I was waiting and I was waiting. And then so it goes. And then she goes like, I was angry. Or he goes, I was angry. And she goes like, I was angry too. And then I left. And then when the A section comes back, they both sing how like, yeah, let's do that again tomorrow. So the problem is they were in different places. She was in like movie theater and then he was at the cafe or something of that sort, or the vice versa, I don't know. I hope you enjoy. You can hear that in a doo-doo-doo, beep, 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 beep. I'm gonna try to project that part. Unsuccessful date. I hope you enjoy. Thank you. haven't played this ending in a number of months. The guy who wrote this piece, Alexander Zwassman, graduated from Moscow Conservatory with a gold medal in both composition and in piano performance, just like Rachmaninoff did and Scriabin did. Only one of those. He did the gold medal in performance, and in terms of composition, Taneyev flunked him out of his class, so he didn't graduate as a composer. Alexander Scriabin, who wrote the Poem of Fire and Prometheus and just about like all of the big and scary and very mysterious works in the 1920s. He didn't have a degree in this. In either case, tomorrow is gonna be the absolutely last piece of the Well-Tempered Clavier, which is scary and makes me feel very important. So if you feel like that, please tune in. Thank you for being here. Thank you for sending me things, and come back tomorrow.